H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
So what are we trying to return? We are trying to return the final value. Okay, I can write down anything. I can write down, for example, 0.0 also. And that will be accepted because double accepts value declaration in double format, or rather decimal format, or in normal format, that is non-decimal format. So I can put 0.0. I can also put 0. It will not have any kind of problem. But when I see the result in the console of Eclipse, the console result will show me in double format, that is nothing but your decimal format. So I can put return 0 and still I will fetch the result. Okay. So if I want to fetch the result, I have to use a SISO statement out here before the return statement is given. So I can write down the value of the subtraction function is concatenate with the variable C. So what is going to happen if I call this subtraction function, control space bar, and this subtraction function, I have to pass on the values. Now the value of A should be an integer format because that is what we have defined this particular value. So I will pass on, let's say 20, and the value of B can be in double format. When we declare the value of a double format, it can be in double format, that is nothing but decimal format, or in non-decimal format. So let me put this value in non-decimal format. So let's say 10.0 and put a terminator sign. Okay, so the resultant value will be 20 minus 10.0 equal to 10.0, and that will be shown in the Eclipse console when we run this class file. So the compiler moves from left to right and top to down. When it encounters this particular function in line number 11, it directly goes to the body part of the subtraction, does this particular subtraction, put the value in a variable C which is of double format, and then prints out the value, and return is 0. And return 0 is accepted, or 0.0 is accepted, because double accepts value declaration in decimal format or in non-decimal format. So I can just run this particular class file after saving. I will get the result as 10.0. But for tangibility and logicalness, instead of putting 0 or 1 or 2, whatever it is, what are we trying to return? We are trying to return the final value, and the final value is kept in C because that is the printout that we are doing. So I will return C. That's all. Save the class file and run it again, and I'll get the same value, 10.0. Okay, now let's understand one more thing. So I'll create one more function, overloading function of subtraction. So I'll copy this and paste it out here. And what I will do is that I will now add one more parameter called float. Float, let's say C, and this C has to be removed with D. Okay, let me not do anything. A minus B minus C. Now you are actually subtracting integer from double and float. So integer minus double minus float. Now in this particular scenario, double still has the highest hierarchy between integer and float. So the resultant value will be double only. And that is why if I put the subtraction of these three to an integer type, let's say integer D, I will get a syntax error because the resultant of this subtraction is nothing but double, because double has the highest hierarchy. So that is why the type mismatch will come. How can you put a double value to a variable D which is of integer type? If I put float also, it will be a problem because the double's hierarchy is the highest in this particular scenario. So that is why it is trying to tell you that type mismatch cannot convert from double to float. That is why I will create a variable B which should be of double format, and that is the reason for us. And then what are we trying to return? We are trying to return we will try to return the final value. The final value is kept in the variable D, so I'll write down return D. And in this particular instance, instead of putting the SISO statement out here, I will leave it blank. Okay, and let's see if I go up and call up this overloading function of subtraction, that is this one, and pass on the values. So let's say the value of A, that is of integer type, should be 100. B is of double type, so double type can be, let's say, 20 or 20.0, whatever we can keep. Double accepts value declaration in decimal and non-decimal format. So let's say I keep it in decimal format. Float accepts value declaration in non-decimal format. So I'll put the value as 10. And I'll put a terminator sign out here. Now I have called the subtraction function and I save the class file and run it. I will see that I was expecting a value of 100 minus 20. Is 80.0 minus 10 is equal to 70.0. Okay, and the resultant value will be in double format because double has the highest hierarchy. Now I'm not getting that value of 70.0. Again, show you. I'm not getting the value of 70.0. Okay, or I can also choose. I'm not getting that value. Now, why is the value not coming in the console? That is 70.0. That is because of the fact that I will get the result in the console only when I use the println command. Now, what I have done in this particular example is that I have removed, or rather I have commented the println command. So, since I have commented the println command, I don't get the result in the console of 70.0. Okay, so what should I do? So what I can do is that I will call this particular function, and the value of the function is what? Manually I can say the value of the function is 70.0, but why it is not throwing out in the console? Because I have commented the println command. So under this circumstances, okay, what I can do, I can put this value to a variable. Let's say I can put this value to a variable, let's say double D, okay, with a small d, okay, and then I can use a SISO statement and write down the value of the overloading function of subtraction is d. Now if you look at the subtraction, this overloading function of subtraction, what are the return type? Return type is double. What it is returning? It is returning a value of d which is also in double format. Okay, now what is going to happen? I am trying to get the value of subtraction which I was not getting because I have commented purposely the println command out here. That is why I was not getting the console result. So what I can do is that I can call the function, put the value of the function inside a variable called d. Now since the return type of this particular function is double, ensure that the value that you are putting for the subtraction function should be also in a variable which should be of double data type. And after putting it in double data type, you can use this println command and it will give you the value. So if I save the class file and run it, I'll get the value at 70.0. And if you see, this is the string part that I had written inside the println command. That is nothing but out here. And I'm getting the value of 70.0 in the console of your Eclipse. This is another way to get the println, or rather the result in the console. Now I was telling you, what is this return type of this function? Double. What it is returning? It is returning double. So if I put an integer out here it is going to show me a syntax error. Why? It is going to say that type mismatch cannot convert from double to integer. So what is the resultant or final result of the subtraction function being called? The final result is double, because that is what you are returning out here. Okay, so that is why if you put this value to an integer variable, this type mismatch is going to come, stating that cannot convert from double to integer. That is why I made this variable as with a double data type. Okay, now I can again call the subtraction function, the same overloading function of subtraction. Okay, and what I can do is, let me pass on the values, let's say 200. Let's say this is an double type value I have to pass, let's say 2.0, and this is a float type, let's say 4. So 200 minus 2.0 is 198.0, minus 4 is 194.0. Okay, put a terminator sign. Now let's say I put it specifically to integer type variable. Now please understand, the value of this is in double format, and that is what you are returning out here. Okay, so that is why you need to put it in the inside a double variable, but purposely I'll put an integer e. Okay, now it is going to tell me type mismatch. Okay, now you are going to hover your mouse over this red underline, add cast to integer. Casting can be done to actually change the data type format. So cast it. So this casting is done. Now casting is done in such a manner that this double format is converted to an integer format by using this casting. And casting is always given within the parentheses before the code having the double format type, and within the parentheses you define what type of data that you want to convert to. So I'm trying to convert the double type data to an integer data type. So this you can do as a casting part. And after casting, you can get, I'll just copy this and print out. I can just print out that the value of the variable overloading function of subtraction is E. Save the class file and I'll get the result as 194 only, not 194.0, 194 only. Why? Because I've converted the double format using the casting method into an integer format. So I can put this in, now it has been converted to integer format, I can put to a variable which is of integer type. This is one way. Next things that we need to understand is, I will again call the overloading function of subtraction, and I'm going to pass, let's say, 1000, because A is of integer type parameter, B is of double type parameter, so I'll pass on 200.0, or I can pass on 200 also, and I can pass on float, which is of 300. The resultant value will be 1000 minus 200 is 800, 800 minus 300 is equal to 500. Now, if I run this particular class file, I'll not get the value of this. So what is going to happen is that I have to put it to a variable. So what I'll do is that I'll put it to a specifically an integer type variable. Now the return, the final return that I am doing is of double type. That is why I'm returning a double type result. So that means this function is going to return a double type result. I'm putting it to integer. Let's say integer f. Obviously, there will be a syntax error. Hover your mouse. The next option that is given is change type of f to double. Change it to double. Your syntax error goes. Okay. I'll remove this again. I'll make it back to integer f. Or the third option that is given is that change return type of subtraction to integer. You see that? It is trying to tell us that change the function called subtraction to an integer return type. So I can come out here. Okay. I can change the return type as integer. Okay. Now I'm basically subtracting a minus b minus c. Now resultant value will be double. correct? Now I'm putting it to double D. Okay, but if you like, you'll see the return statement is showing you a syntax error. Why? Because the return type that we have defined for the subtraction was an integer. What are you returning? You're returning a value which is of double type. That is why there's a type mismatch. Cannot convert from double to integer. This is in double format. This is in integer format. It has to pass on the final value, which should be of integer format. How do I do that? So what I can do is that I can actually put the value of D. Put the value of D into a integer variable called E, and then cast it. How do I cast it? That means I'm trying to convert this double format into an integer format. So first I have to do casting. Casting is possible by putting the. So I want to convert it to integer format. So this is an integer casting, INT. After casting, this turns to an integer format. Then you can put it to a variable E, which is of integer format. And then what you are trying to return? You have to return E, because there is no variable called D in this particular parameter, nor in the body of the subtraction function. That is why it is showing you a syntax error. Type cannot convert from double to int. So this is in double. This is in int. So what I will do, I will have to pass on the final return value, which should be integer format, so that I will call up E out here. And your syntax error goes, and then your syntax error goes out here. If I put it to back to D, so I'm returning a double format value. So this will have a problem. So I put it back to E, and then I can put it this function into a, so the final value of the subtraction function is nothing but is in an integer format or nothing but a integer data type. So I am putting it to integer variable, so that is why compiler is accepting it, and then I can use the SISO statement out here. Control C and Control V. This is F. Right now I'll get the value of this subtraction function being called as 1000 minus 200 is 800, 800 minus 300 is 500, not 500.0, because I am returning the value to an integer data type variable. Run this class file after saving, I will get 500. So that's about it. Thanks. And if you have any questions, you can revert to us. Thanks for the patience.